computing normal probabilities in Minitab. Whether your distribution is modeled with the normal distribution, given a mean and a standard deviation, or you have already computed a z-score, you can use Minitab to look up a probability. You can go to Calc, Probability Distributions, Normal. In an introductory statistics class, we will not use the first option in Minitab, Probability Density. Instead, we'll be looking up a less than or equal to probability. Minitab calls this cumulative probability. And if we're given the probability in advance and we want to reverse the process and look up the value of x or z, we'll use the inverse cumulative probability option. Let's say that we're looking at a normal distribution with a mean of 2 and a standard deviation of 1. We would like to find the probability that x is less than or equal to 4. In Minitab, this is a cumulative probability. Once we have selected this, which is the default, we can then enter the mean and standard deviation. In our example, the mean is 2, and the standard deviation is 1. Since we're computing just one probability, the probability that x is less than or equal to 4, we'll select input constant and enter 4. When we click OK, Minitab will tell us the cumulative probability. That's right here. Now let's reverse the process. Let's say the probability was given to us. Let's say the cumulative probability is 0.50. We want to find the value of x that is at the 50th percentile. We will go back to Calc, Probability Distributions, Normal. Since we are reversing the process, we want an inverse cumulative probability. The mean is still 2 and the standard deviation is 1, so I do not have to change that part. But for the input constant, we will enter that cumulative probability that was already given to us, 0.50. Please do not enter a fraction into this area. Use the decimal format. When we click OK, Minitab first tells us the cumulative probability that we asked for. Then it tells us the value of 2. That's the answer that we're looking for. This is a little different than the output for the binomial and Poisson distributions. Let's say you already converted your normal distribution into a z-score, or the standard normal distribution. We can use the same operation in Minitab to compute the probability. We'll go back to Calc, Probability Distributions, Normal. Let's say we computed a z-score of -3, and we want to know the probability that z is less than that value. That's a cumulative probability. The mean and standard deviation need to be changed to fit the standard normal distribution. The mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. If we want the probability that z is less than or equal to -3, -3 is the input constant. When we hit OK, Minitab will give us the cumulative probability. Let's reverse the process. Let's say for the standard normal distribution, we want to know the value of z that is at the 0.975 percentile. We'll go back to Calc, Probability Distributions, Normal. We are reversing the process. That's called an inverse cumulative probability. For the standard normal distribution, z, the mean is 0 and the standard deviation is 1. The input constant is that probability that's given to us, the 0.975. When we click OK, Minitab will give us the value of z. First, Minitab tells us the probability that we asked for. Next, it tells us that actual value of z. Usually, we round this up to 1.96.